you're not going to sleep for about 15 to 20 minutes. Put another stand. What are we going to do for the next 15 to 20 minutes? Why are we waiting? Everybody's quiet. Everyone seems to be here. All the chairs were filled. All the people were gathered around. And what happened next completely blew me away. The parents of Gilad Shamir, who I'm very friendly with, their names are Bakalim and Ophir Shamir, stood at the foot of their son's grave, commemorating his yard sale, and led the hundreds of people who were there in 15 minutes of uninterrupted song from Shir HaShir, talking about their expression of love, talking about the description of their dedication to God Himself, trying to feel and express their unwavering commitment to God Himself and to everything that He has given them in their own lives. And I sat there and I cried, not so much because it brought back the memories of the entire story and how painful it is to think about children who suffer, about children whose lives are brutally taken away like the way theirs were. I cried more because I felt that I was so distant from these kinds of people. I felt that my understanding and appreciation for God is nowhere near the understanding and appreciation that these people have somehow, heroically, developed. That's why I cried. Because when I asked myself, Ayeka, where are we? The question, the penetrating question that God expects all of us to ask ourselves. Was I able to really answer that question the way these people can answer it? Was I really able to say that I have that same feeling and that same love when things are difficult in my own life? Am I able to say that I can accept it the same way people like this are able to accept it? It was a profound learning experience for me, but it was something I'll never forget. I couldn't even speak afterward. What is one supposed to say? What can you possibly say on an occasion like that, when this is the reaction, when this is the response? The only thing one can think of is, if this is the response that God's children have to Him when life is sometimes difficult, and when the dynamics of our relationship with Him sometimes change, can you imagine the love in response that God must have for all of us? Can you imagine and ever understand why it is that God has promised us Ki Lo Yitosh Hashem Amo? When you see that there are Jews throughout all the millennia who are willing to still go to shul and who are willing to still keep every Shabbos, even though they cannot wait to ask God all their difficult questions, and they cannot wait to deal with God in a very serious way and asking those questions, the same ones that Avraham Avinu asked. He's still Avraham Avinu Tameh. One has a right to sometimes wonder, how could it be? What is it that God wants from me? How is it that I'm supposed to internalize His message? But we know that in the end, Yoshev HaShamayim Yisrael, throughout all these iniquitous attempts to destroy the Jewish people, God in the end always knows that His people will be strong, that Am Yisrael Chayim will continue to be the incredible legacy that the Jewish people are, and that we will give that over to our children, which is the greatest thing you can do for your parents. Your father, as you mentioned, passed away at a very young age. What greater nechama can a family have? What greater consolation can ever be offered than to show your father that you are developing new communities, that you are helping to bring Torah to next generation of Jews after your father is no longer able to be that person who was able to do it, and to have this curiosity that he had for religion, the curiosity that he had for all different chachmas, for all different ideas, for so many different aspects of life. What greater gift can you give back to him than to show him that Am Yisrael, that his people, that he so firmly